science can be really enlightening and humbling and empowering. And I think what can get people caught up, or I've seen this happen to me too, is that you take things personally. Like, you want a result, you want an answer to be the certain answer. And I think it's really important in science to detach yourself. It's not about us, it's just about the truth. My name is Leila. I'm pregnant. I'm having a baby, my first baby. I have a dog. I love my dog. He's really part of my family. I'm a scientist. I work on AAVs, which is a tool that people use for gene therapy. An AAV is an adeno-associated virus. It's a really common virus. We never hear about it really because it doesn't cause disease in humans. And so we can modify a lot of aspects of that virus to tailor it to be able to treat specific diseases. So AAVs are really good at getting to a specific location in your body, and that property makes them really efficient delivery tools for whatever's on the inside. So in this case, it would be a gene that you need. Being in nature really gives me kind of the perspective of time and how things can progress over long times. You can see like the vastness of how landscapes have developed, how different plants have grown, or how ecosystems develop. And I think it helps me to keep that perspective of, I'm not that powerful in my lifetime, but at least I can like start carving out a little path or ask the question that can get other people involved and start something that's going to take a while to learn about. One of the things that's really exciting about the future of AAVs is using AAVs to treat really common neurological diseases like Alzheimer's, like Parkinson's. The potential for gene therapy is that it would be something they would get once, and then it would really get at the root of what's causing their disease. It could lead to a long-term or permanent benefit.